a technician providing innovation to my friends tomorrow to make it through. And therefore, you have the following strategy. I play academic game. I want to get a prize. I want to be promoted. I want to be professor and so on. Or I want to have a patent. I want to become consultant and so on. And again, you have the fact that, for example, economists are frequently concerned when they are finding new techniques. They earn a lot of money. For example, give you an example, Robert Merton invented a measure for measuring bubbles. He had a consultancy, and he became millionaire selling the forecast. You see the point? So it's interesting. You have an economic breakthrough, and you earn a lot of money. So understand, it is a permanent phenomenon in economics. And you have very rarely consultancy in anthropology or in history, whereas in economics is there. And again, you have the probability of finding new theory and finding new techniques. And to find a new theory in science, social science is very difficult. To find a new technique may be probably easier. Therefore, you have to choose between the two elements. And again, you have a threshold of probability. You need to have a sufficient high probability compared with, because this term is the term of becoming rich by familiar techniques against being a good academic. So this parameter will play a major role in the fact that you select to be technician or theoretician, in spite of the fact that even in the case that in the long run academic rate of return are superior, but given the personal interest, you will devote to techniques. So again, you see the very simple game.